What's it like to launch a startup in Singapore? We talk to founders who have done it, find out what success looks like for them, and the challenges they've overcome. This is Simon Gush, CEO of Equatorial Space. The company builds rockets and is currently developing its first suborbital system. Why did you start Equatorial Space?
One of my favorite movies when I was growing up was actually Apollo 13. I was obsessed with it, and I refused to let go of this dream and aspiration. I decided to take some decisive steps in realizing it. So that was back in 2018 when I was still an undergraduate here at NUS. Singapore is very well situated for space launch, and I thought the industry was ripe for disruption, and that's how the idea for Equatorial Space was initially conceived.
What was your breakthrough moment?
Soon after our inception, we have been invited for a pitch competition in Dubai, organized by the Space Center, MBRSC. I flew in without expecting too much, done my absolute best, and we have actually won that competition. We won a cash prize of $30,000, and that was more money than we've seen before until that point. It would be very difficult for us to attract the right talent and raise the capital required without having crossed that first piece of validation from somebody.
What's the coolest thing you've done?
In 2020, we were in dire straits. We were, few of us, if paid, were paid much. And I was personally sleeping on my friend's floor. The company was about to basically shut down, but we still managed to launch our first demonstrator in December that year. That was the first commercially developed rocket prototype that was flown in this part of the world up until that point. We had no idea if that thing is really going to work, all the way until we came down to that site. When that rocket ignited, there are some moments in your life that just sear into your mind like a branding iron. And that was one of those moments. Seeing it fly in that glorious, glamorous thunder. That was the coolest thing we've done so far.
What's one piece of advice for someone setting up a startup?
I was a huge idealist and a huge optimist in the beginning. And I think you have to be if you are to start a company in the first place. As you become more experienced, I think that you have to start balancing it off with realism, and with being a little more measured. And I think I've gotten much better at balancing these two over the years.